We are back. What is up, everyone? Welcome back to the stream. It's me. It's MD Tenebris. I'm back again to bring you some more mediocre Pokemon play. Below me on the screen, I have two links. The purple is the link to my Twitch. That's where I am now. I'm here every Saturday at 2, every Monday at 6:30. The red link is the link to my YouTube. That's MD Tenebris Plays Pokemon. All of my back catalog is there if you want to go check out any more of my videos. Maybe just look at the deck list in the information box. It's all good. If you like the content, feel free to drop a like. It lets me know what to make more of. Right. So, also, in the information box on this video, there should be a link to a Discord channel. If you want to join the Discord channel, catch me offline, you know, talk to me about anything Pokemon related, feel free to do it there. Everyone is welcome. Okay, so today, oh, I'm excited. Today, this is one of my favorite Pokemon. It's Slaking. He's always such a pain in the ass to use in the games for no good reason. I guess they're trying to give him, like, super... He had super, super ridiculous stats in the games. But here, they're kind of taking him down a notch. So, we're going to be doing this Slaking deck. We got the Stir and Snooze ability. Here, if this Pokemon is asleep, flip two coins instead of one during Pokemon checkup. If either of them is Tails, this Pokemon is still asleep, right? Which sucks. And then obviously you got Slacker's Head Strike, 240. This Pokemon is now asleep. So the whole design of this card is to put this Pokemon to sleep and to keep him asleep. And obviously you don't want that if you are going to be trying to do damage. Hey, Phase Leader, bright and early. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. Hope you are having a good day today. Alright, so, because of this ability, we've paired the Slaking with this Blissey, right? We got the Busy Body Nurse ability here. Once during your turn, you may use this ability. Your active Pokemon recovers from all special conditions. Fantastic. So, we would love to have that. It also does have this Happy Cyclone move, where it does 150 damage, not bad. Move all energy from this Pokemon to one of your bench Pokemon. So, you could almost use it as like a sacrifice, like a last strike, kind of just get 150 damage on quick, put the energy onto your Slaking, for instance, or another Pokemon. As we will see, I have a couple in here. We have the Bibarel in here, right, for our draw engine. We got the Industrious Incisors. Once during your turn, you may draw cards until you have 5 cards in your hand. Okay, we also have the Arceus V and V Star Chain. We have this in here specifically for the Starbirth ability. It's really, really useful to be able to go and grab two cards, especially in a deck that's kind of would like to have an Irita in here, but does not because it's not a water-type deck. I decided not to go in that direction. So we've got the Arceus V-Star in here instead, so we can use the Starbirth ability to go grab a rare candy, for instance, go grab a Slaking or a Slakoth, whichever we need. We also have the Radiant Jirachi in here. If this Pokemon is in the active spot, it's knocked out. Buy damage from an opponent's Pokemon, search your deck for 3 cards, and put them into your hand, and then shuffle your deck, right? And then ask for misfortune, flip 2 coins, if both of them are heads, your opponent's active Pokemon is knocked out, right? So that's kind of nasty as well. You could take out a VMAX Pokemon with that, very sneaky, kind of coming through. We also have this Wigglytuff in here with the Balloon Therapy. Once during your turn, you may attach a therapeutic energy card from your hand to one of your Pokemon. Now, we do have a lot of energy, I mean, ability Pokemon in here, making us quite weak to things like Tinglu. So we also do have the reversal energy, right? If we're running behind, if we have more prize cards than our opponent, we can attach this to an evolution Pokemon like our Slaking. Gives 3 energy at a time, so it takes 1 energy to load them up, which is nice. We also have this therapeutic energy, which stops your Pokemon from being asleep, confused, or paralyzed, so our Slaking will not be suffering from that, allowing us to do, unfortunately, the measly 240 damage per turn, which isn't great. It is coming from a single prize card Pokemon. It does take a little bit of time to set up, so it's not the most capable deck as of yet. You might want stronger attackers in here. I kind of went in the direction of just having the Slaking. The Arceus is useful to do damage from time to time, but I'm not like super involved. The 200 is nice, but it's less than the 240. You're not going to be taking out V-Stars. It's going to be a little tricky with VMAX Pokemon as well. But that's okay. That's okay. I've been enjoying it so far. Yeah, mine has been okay. I got no plans for later. I was just doing some gardening, so I'm pretty tired. My arm hurts as well, which is never fun. But feeling good. Feeling excited. I do really like the slacking Pokemon. I hate how they always mess him up. If they really want to do something like this Stern Snooze thing, he should have like 230 HP. Let's be real. The reason slacking in the games was so far behind in terms of his ability was because they gave that Pokemon like more stats than a legendary Pokemon. So it was like, it was just this fantastic anomaly of this like fat ape-like monkey Pokemon that was just ridiculously stronger than everything else, but then only went every other turn. You know, the 240, it's not the most damage you're going to see out here nowadays, especially with stacking moves. And for three energy, you know, I think what they could have done is they should either have this be two energy so you can load him up quicker and then you can go, but obviously I think the reversal energy was built for this Pokemon as well. Or I think they should have given you like 250, 260 damage. That would have been nice. Then you can maybe throw in like a Vitality Belt into this deck and you actually might have a shot. Yeah, so we'll see. But I'm excited. I do like the Pokemon. It's a fun one. So let's take it out. I got the wrong deck on select. I was testing out a Lunala Mousehold deck. This one here. With the double the damage counters and then using the mouse hold to try and put a bunch of damage counters on quickly and clean up at the end of the game with the Lunala. But not the best deck right now, so that's to come. Also was playing around with a Venusaur Bramblin deck that might be coming up soon. That's an interesting one. It's not very strong. I'll give you that. Okay. Yeah, I have no plans. Just going to play some Pokemon. Enjoy my Saturday. I had my girlfriend's birthday yesterday, so I actually had the day off yesterday, so it feels like Sunday today, so it's really messing with me. But it's a good day. I've had a good time so far. It's been nice and easy. And we're gonna get right into this. It's ready for this. It looks like it's gonna be a fire type deck. From the coin, we're gonna see. We're gonna cheers. I don't have any lime for my Coronas today. It's a pity. I left the lime slices out last night and they dried out and I'm snooty as hell. Can't be putting dried lime out in your Corona. Gotta be fresh. Alright, so we have one basic Pokemon. We have two actually. We have the Vigoroth as well. Do we want to play the Slakoth forward first? Wait, what the fuck? It didn't even give me a timer. Wow. Okay. That fucked me over. I was going to play the Slakoth into the starting position. That's not cool. What the fuck? Wow. Fucking Pokemon Live, huh? Just sets your starting Pokemon for you without a warning. That's garbage. What the hell is that? It's not my fault they mulligan. Like, give me a fucking break. That's crazy. Timer should have shut up or something. Yeah, right, man? Pokemon Live thing's ridiculous. Alright, select. We got a Bibarel. Interesting. We can't evolve it, though. We are up against two Bidoofs. Okay. I'm guessing this is going to be the Arcanine EX deck. It's going to be tough to beat this one. This is one of those decks that's really, really strong right now. I love PTCGL. Go phase leader. There you go. Alright, so we're going to play the Clavel. Grab a bunch of Bidoof and Slaking and Chansey and Jirachi and everything. Do we want another Slaking? We have one line. No. I think we're just going to go over these three. That's fine. We throw the Chansey up here. I'm not too concerned about, like, ability tampering from, like, a Tinglu deck. So I'm not trying to hide anything right now. So I could retreat the Bidoof and put the Radiant Jirachi up in place instead. But I'm going to see if I can get... like a switch or something. No, I don't. I'm gonna put that therapeutic energy on too. Ooh. Yeah. That might hurt. We'll see. We'll see. We have the Chansey in play, so, like, you know, if we get a Blissey, which we can with the Arezu, like, I wouldn't need the therapeutic energy attached to the Slakoth. I could have played that onto any Pokemon. So, they have a Professor's Research there. Getting rid of... Wait, what the f... Why wouldn't you put... Why wouldn't you evolve the Growlithe and play the Stadium? Wait, what? I don't understand that. That's weird as hell. You would play the... You would evolve the Growlithe into the Arcanine and play the Stadium and use the Stadium to put... Because the Arcanine even have a It has a move that scales with damage. What the... This attack does 10 more damage for each damage counter on this Pokemon. So you can use the Magma Basin. You get like 40 damage free on your Pokemon. Radiant Charizard. What the hell is this guy? I'm not sure what Ready For This is ready for, but it does not seem to be to play against me in this deck. I'm not sure what they're doing. Maybe they're like playing chess when I'm playing checkers. This is very confusing for me. I'm not sure. And I absolutely hate the background for the normal type Pokemon. What the fuck is this coloring? This is disgusting. It's like puke yellow with like turquoise, sea green, and like pink puce. I don't get the combination of colors. Is there nothing better you could do for normal type? All right, what are we gonna do? Rant over Bibarel. We're gonna evolve him. We're gonna go for the Vigoroth here. We got a double energy as well, so we're gonna go Arezu. We're gonna grab ourselves the Blissey. We're gonna grab ourselves. We do not have another Bibarel. That's not cool. I guess we might as well grab the Vigoroth. Oh, we can grab three. Oh, I don't want to grab three, though, because I want to use the Bibarel move. So we're just going to grab the Blissey. That's the only one I can use right now. That's a shame. We're going to go Blissey onto there. Do we want to put the double turbo on, retreat the Bidoof, and play the Jirachi and get ourselves forward more? Or do we want to attach the double turbo to the Vigoroth so we can attack next? Let's see what we pull with the Bibarel. We'll decide from there. I think that's wise. We got a Slakoth and an Ultra Ball. Okay, so we're gonna go slacking here. Dang, this is tough. I am gonna retreat the Bidoof. This is a single prize card deck. I don't really want to waste that advantage that we have. I know I don't have any energies currently in my hand, which is making me uncomfortable, but that's okay. We're going to end our turn. We have a judge for next turn, so I'm going to evolve my Vigoroth into a Slaking, hopefully without manipulation from the opponent. And then I will play the judge, and we'll get four new cards. I can use the Bibarel ability. We will see what we get, hopefully. We got a couple of reversal energies in here, so we kind of need them to be ahead for us to be... We need them to be ahead for our deck to be able to, like, put the energy on super quick. And they're retreating it. Who are they retreating for? Is it the Charizard? Who are they retreating this for? This is a very... I'm very confused. It is the Charizard. Do they not get how the Charizard works? I don't know. Oh, we got the reversal energy we were looking for. So, we're going to evolve this guy. I might just play it. It only works on evolution Pokemon. Alright. Gonna play it onto here. Yeah. I am gonna judge now, and then I'm gonna use the Bibarel after. We're gonna see. I know he didn't have a ton of cards, so that wasn't the best. We got a Vigoroth, that's great. Put the Vigoroth onto there. And then we can use the Bibarel on the like the last three. If we get a double turbo, I want to play it on this Radiant Jirachi, and I can't because I already played the reversal, so that was a little dumb, but that's okay. We're gonna end the turn. Double turbo's nice. We do have V-Guard energy now as well. This is gonna be an Arcanine EX deck, so I don't think we're gonna see any V Pokemon now that we played through it a little bit. But we'll see. We will see. Another Growlithe. and the Defiance Band, and the XP Share. Very interesting. Okay. So we're gonna go slacking here. We're gonna go, we don't need any, oh, we could go for the Bibarel, the second Bibarel, instead of the youngster. I'm gonna play that under there for sure. Maybe we'll go Jack. We'll grab the Bibarel first. Is it here? We don't have it. Did we already check for that as well? Christ. Let's see what we got here. I guess that's... Nah, we're gonna leave it. No, we're gonna take it, whatever. Yes! Stop putting pressure on me, I don't like it. Alright, now we'll play the Bibarel. I didn't want to take it because I didn't want to have so many cards in my hand. I didn't need it because I didn't have the... Yeah, exactly. So now I'm like cucked. Alright, that's fine. And now we're going to play our Astro Misfortune. Let's go. Flip two coins. If both are heads, we get a free knockout. And as soon as one is tails, you know you didn't get it. But that's okay. Because, like, we literally only have this Radiant Jirachi in here to die. Right? Once it gets knocked out, we get to go and search for three cards, unless they use poison or they use damage counters or something sneaky. So we're feeling good. We're feeling pretty good. 29 to 31. We're like 2 minutes ahead. Yeah, they seem to not be playing their deck right. I still don't understand that first move. Like, you could have had an Arcanine. You could have had the Magma Basin in play. You could have been putting an energy on from your discard each turn. You would have had four energies attached by now to whichever Pokemon you wanted, and you would have still gotten the seven new cards from the Professor's Research. I just don't understand why they played it like that. We have a switch. Okay. We're going to attach... I guess we're going to attach the V-Guard energy to this slacking for now. So now he can hit regardless. We can switch for to knock out the Radiant Charizard. That's fine. We can start getting prize cards. Because this is only one energy now, I believe, right? Yeah. Okay, perfect. We have the Blissey in play, so I'm not concerned about that. We are going to go for the youngster now. See what we get. Bibarel is clearly in our prize cards. We got the Avery. Interesting. We can't use any... We could use the Ultra Ball to get rid of it, but I would prefer to save that. Maybe go and grab another Pokemon. So we're just going to go for the Slacker's Head Strike. Knock out this Radiant Charizard, no problem. So now the Charmander has an energy. I don't know what their plan is. This person is confusing me a little bit. And they're taking a while per turn, so, like, they might just not know how to play their deck. This seems like a pretty bare-bones Arcanine EX deck. It might even be the official Arcanine EX deck, I'm not sure. They might have disconnected. No, I've seen them do stuff on their turn. Man, they're taking a while to decide if they want to move that fire energy to the Growlithe or not. Pokemon live things, huh? No doubt, absolutely not. Let me check what this what the PokéX word is saying today. I love that game. So they did not move an energy. They put it into their discard pile. I have the Crushing Hammer. I'm feeling good. I think this game's pretty much over. Let me go and find the PokéX word so I have something to do while this goofball is choosing a new active Pokemon. I guess they've DC'd or something else has happened and it's just waiting for the timers to tick enough. Okay, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 letters long, it's a Dark-type Pokemon. 8 letters long, Dark-type Pokemon. Garbodor? G. Let me see. Garbodor. It's not Garbodor, but that's the right number of letters. Yeah, this clown is disconnected or something. The new hint is surprise attack. It's got two R's and an O. There we go. Okay, they were inactive for too long. So we got the win by default. GG. Good try. Ready for this. I don't know why you play your deck like that. Seemed a little silly, but we got the win. That's one win for the slacking deck. We are already doing much better than I had anticipated. Win. Loss. Okay, we got the chart set up. That's a win. Gonna go right back in. Right back in. Yeah, I'm excited for this Lunala deck that I'm putting together as well. I might play that one next stream on Monday. No, it is. It's 100% over. I'm just gonna surrender. This is a waste of time. The Tankaton is a pretty tough deck to beat with a normal deck. I like that look, the pink and the brown skirt. They only had green and white skirts last time I checked, so I guess they've added more skirts to the game. We're on the leggings vibe now, though. The leggings look very good. Look at this damn Pokemon. We're just gonna go right back into a new game. Haven't had the greatest starts. We still pulled out a win on one. So that's one win, one loss on the day so far. I'm starting to get hot. I gotta turn my Steven fan up. Yeah, this game. Fuck this. Damn, man. We got so lucky. And then had to be the Radiant Greninja. It's in a ton of decks. It makes it really hard to play single prize card decks because this Radiant Greninja that just takes him out, takes two Pokemon out, evens the stage. Kind of sucks, you know. You wish there wasn't a single prize card out there that could take out two prize cards like that. I guess the Lunala is a good example of another one. So that's two losses on the day. One win, two losses. Dang, man. Not the best. I wasn't expecting a ton out of this deck because I still think it's kind of a weak deck. I haven't put a ton of power boosting in, so it is just the 240 damage if you are behind and you get the reversal energy on your third stage. So it's a little hard to access compared to every other deck out there, basically. But I should probably have the slacking as like a side effect in a different deck. But that's okay. We got a Tails Flipper going up against Amoeba TV here. I will go first. Thank you very much. That's not Garbodor. Mars. Oh, scheiße. What's this gonna be? We got a Slack Off to start. Not the best. Two bosses orders an Avery. I'm probably going to use Steel type. Okay, interesting. So, I don't think it is Chien Pao. I think it's going to be Dialga or something like that. Maybe they got the Chien Pao on there to discourage fire decks from playing against them. Cool. That does not help tons. Yeah, it is the Dialga deck. There you go. Oh, and the Arceus V-Star. Okay, so we're going to play a Therapeutic Energy onto the Slakoth. We're going to end the turn. That's all we can do because it's our first turn. And we do not have any item cards in our hand. I guess I'm either going to go Avery and see if I can pull the RCSV or the Chansey, and then I will probably go for the Judge after that, depending on what else I get. But we're going to see. Judge might help them as well. They might not have a great hand. These Steel decks are kind of clunky. But we're going to see. Interesting that they put it on the Magnemite. Okay. So they're going for the Magnemite. Search for your three energy cards from your discard pile. Put them in your deck, but they don't have any energy cards in their discard pile. Okay, so they're searching for an item card and a tool. Maybe they're going for an Ultra Ball, and then they could discard two, and they could go and find the Dialga V-Star and evolve that next turn. That'd be a nice play. Rare Candy. Okay, they're Rare Candying the Magnemite. All right.
So then they can use the Magnezone's ability to go search their deck for 6 energy cards and attach them to your Pokemon in any way you like. That's pretty OP. This Dialga V-Star is going to be up and running pretty quick. We just got the Slackoth here. Dang, man. I'm not getting the best setups. Should we judge to get rid of that rare candy now? Yeah, you know, we probably should. They don't have anything to get rid of with the Avery. So I'm going to do that. Get rid of that rare candy. Nullify the Arvin move. We did get a Chansey now, which is great. That is great. And we can use Yawn, so we can actually put the Magnemite to sleep. There we go. And its Tails is still asleep, so it can't use its move, even if it discards Steel Energies. I think it also, I'm not sure, can you retreat? You can't retreat when you're paralyzed, and you can't retreat, I think, when you're asleep. But you can retreat when you're confused, poisoned, and... Ah, there you go. Well, he can retreat now anyways. Interesting that the Magneton only has one retreat cost. You'd think a Steel-type Pokemon would have a higher retreat cost at Stage 1. My Slackoth has 2 for retreat costs, so that's no fun. We're gonna go V-Star Guard here. We're not gonna use the Crushing Hammer because then they can use the move. Going Youngster, very nice, very nice. So we got another Chansey here. We got the Nest Ball that we're gonna play. And they do have an Avery, so I gotta be careful about this. We're going Jirachi here. And then we are going to go Bidoof. That's cool. Cool, cool, cool. Maybe we'll play the double... I can't play double turbo. Okay, so we're going to go Yawn here. We're going to put the Magneton to sleep now. And it's going to wake up anyways. It'd be nice if it didn't have that for the first turn. Like, if you always got, like, the first the first burn... And the first sleep flips your way. That'd be pretty cool. Like the paralysis, right? No. Paralysis is just for that next turn. That makes more sense. Alright. So they're starting to load up their Dialgas. They got the Magnezone, so obviously they're going to be able to put a lot of energies on them pretty quick. Hopefully, oh, they didn't get any. They didn't get any energies to start. Fantastic. And if we can take this guy out with the Jirachi, then they're going to be a little stuck. I wish I had a switch here. We're going to retreat. We're going to get rid of the V and the basic energy. That's fine. We're going to play our Radiant Jirachi now. We're going to go for the Irezu here. We're going to go grab some Blissey, some Bidoof, and a Vigoroth. Here we go. No rare candy needed. Okay. Vigoroth here. We got the Blissey. We got the Bibarel. Here. There it is. Wrong card. Whoops. And then we're going to go double turbo onto the Radiant Jirachi. And we're going to go for the Bibarel draw engine here. Industrious and Scissors. What do we get? We get 4 cards. What are they? Very nice. Add another bit of. I'm going to leave him off the bench because I do know they have an Avery in this deck that they have not played yet. We did get a mulligan off of them. We're going to go Ash from his Fortune and hope for 2 heads. Do we get the 2 heads? Heads. No, we did not get the 2 heads. Dang. If we'd gotten the 2 heads and we'd knocked this Magnezone out quick, that would have been very, very good for us. They can use the Giga Magnet ability. They're probably going to get something. If they don't get anything again, I would be impressed. No, they got something this time. Dang it. Okay. I wouldn't be surprised if they attached one to the Magnezone to retreat it. But then you're putting the Dialga V up. Oh, they're going to attack me with a Power Beam. Okay, that's all right. So I'm going to get to draw 3 cards from this, which is nice. Maybe we go get the Arceus. Chansey line looks weak, honestly. Yeah, I mean, the Blissey does 150 damage. We could go for that. There's no RCSV in here, so maybe not. You need maybe we go another Blissey. We use that as our first attack. And then what do we have? We have two reversal energies, so we can put one on the Chansey, one on the... Okay, perfect. Okay, so we're going to go back. I guess a Judge might be good, and then... This would be kind of nasty. All right, so maybe we go like that. So we're gonna play the Blissey. We're gonna get the 150 damage in one hit. We're gonna take this Magnezone out with a single prize card. Right. This is how I think this deck should play. Right. This is like there's no status effect Pokemon in play. The Blissey, the Busybody Nurse, keeps the Slaking from falling asleep. That's what Blissey's there for. I've got the Blissey in here because it means that you can use your ability and you can get rid of the sleep. And you can use the 240 every turn, was the idea. And on top of that, you can hit with this Hyper Cyclone. Do I play the Bidoof onto the bench? You hit with the Hyper Cyclone. And so I'm going to do 150 damage, and I can move all the energy from this Blissey. I can use it as a dispersal to the other Pokemon. You see that? I do have therapeutic energy in here as well. I also have a Wigglytuff in here to help with that. Yeah, we got a couple stuff in here. It's a weird little deck. I've been trying to get it into a better spot. I think you probably want a main attacker, and the Slaking's just like a strong side thing. Maybe it's like a psychic deck mainly with like Wigglytuff and Slaking, and then you have like another main attacker that's like psychic, maybe like a Gardevoir or something like that, EX. You know. I can beat decent decks if I get a decent start. Because the single prize card, you can use the reversal energy, so you can do that 240 per turn as long as you get the Slaking up and running. Okay, so they're going to be playing this Dialga V-Star now. What are we looking at here? So the idea is they knock this Blissey out. I play the other Blissey and attach another reversal energy and do 150 to, okay. They are not going to do that. Okay, Crushing Hammer, let's go. Heads, yes, we got the heads. Hell yes. Okay, so we're gonna take out one of your energies. Thank you. All right, no problemo. And then we're gonna go reversal energy onto here. I think I am gonna play the Bidoof now. I'm gonna go for the youngster, and we're gonna see. I kind of want that reversal energy though. And we're tied, so it doesn't do anything. We're gonna go Judge. We're gonna get rid of the Dialga V-Star. Hopefully they don't get it again. We got a therapeutic energy. Nice. Okay. And we have the Bibarel Draw Engine, so we can go Bibarel Draw Engine. What do we get? An Avery, okay, nice. What would I get with the Ultra Ball? Probably another Bibarel, right? What would I get rid of? I don't know. We're gonna end the turn there. We're gonna see what happens. Maybe play the double turbo energy onto the Blissey and attack for the 150. We're gonna see. So what we did by discarding that one energy on the Dialga was we prevented him from using his main move that would knock out our Blissey. Keeping us in it for a little bit. This reversal energy does operate as one, so I can add the double turbo energy. I can hit for 130 damage, which is okay. But it might be wiser to just retreat and hit with the Slaking for 240 while he's not up and running. Boss's orders. Who is he moving in? The Bibarel, okay. Interesting. Another Bibaro. All right. So the tricky thing is we need to get a switch somehow. I guess we'll attach this therapeutic energy onto the slacking. And we're going to play the Avery. We're going to go for the first Bibaro and see what we get. Give me a switch. Oh, okay. Then I guess maybe we'll go for the Avery. What do we want? I don't want any of these cards really. So we'll go Youngster. I could have used the boss's orders to stall out a little bit. But if he attacks me here, then maybe we get the switch here. Ah, dang. Nah. I guess we use the boost shake now, even though we have the Vigoroth in our hand. We might as well. Okay, nothing there. We can look at the rest of the cards though. How many switches are in the price cards? Neither of them. Okay, good to know. Oh, okay, so hopefully the idea is the Bibaro, they're going to take out the Bibaro with the Temporal Rupture, and then I can move the Slaking into position, and I can hit for 240. And if they take out the Bibaro, that's going to hurt a little bit. We're going to go like this. One, two, that's fine. If they take out the Bibaro and they evolve it to the Dialga V-Star, then I would put the Blissey forward and I would hit for the 150 because we have access to the reversal energies again once they take out the Bibaro. And I would expect this to be for the Dialga V-Star, so we're going to see. I do think that move allows them to go twice, though. I'm not 100% sure how we're going to play this. We're going to have to sacrifice something. I guess it will be the Blissey. This Blissey. We have therapeutic energies on the slacking, so that should be okay. And then we'll definitely be far enough behind to do the reversal energies, which is nice. We got to see, though. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. Okay, so we're going to play this Blissey next. And they can't use the Star Kronos anymore, but they can use this one. 4 times 6 is going to be 240. Oh, that makes life tricky. Nice. Okay, so that's going to take 30 off each time. 20 less each time. So we're going to do 130, and then we're going to do 220. That is still enough to take out the V-Star. I have to hope they don't get another V-Star. As long as this guy stays one-hittable, I should be okay. And I'm surprised they're putting more energy onto this guy. Like, you don't need to be putting more energy onto that guy. So we're going to play this Blissey here. Man, I should have another Slaking or Slakoth to put this on. But they use the Avery, so dang. Okay, we are gonna go Happy Cyclone here. That's okay. We're gonna do the 130. That's right. So they can take this guy, and they'll have 2 left. I can take this guy, and I will have 3 left. And then I'm hoping they don't get the V Star. That's the hope. Oh, this is a tough game, man. They got the V-Star. Fuck that. They do not have the V-Star ability anymore, though. Tool Jammer. Okay. Oof, man. This is gonna be a tough game. I mean, I'm definitely always the underdog when I'm playing these single prize card decks. so many of these kids can't compete in competitive with these very competitive normal decks. Like, you should be playing in standard ranked ladder. You shouldn't be playing standard casuals with this kind of deck. But that's okay. Not everyone can be as good as me at this game. We have the Avery, so we can actually get revenge on them. And they can discard something. We got an Ultra Ball, so we can go for the slacking, I guess. Alrighty. Alright. Ultra Ball. We're gonna go... 1, 2... Maybe I'll get rid of the Wiggly... I'll hold on. I'll get rid of the Vigoroth, because we have the Rare Candy, right? Done. I'm gonna go for the slacking. Hopefully we can find the slacking come through. That would be very nice. We're gonna go therapeutic energy onto there. I am gonna hit for the 220. They're gonna be able to do 120 damage, unless they evolve this into the Magna Zone next turn. So we're gonna see. We got the slacking. Okay, that's great. That's great. That's really, really great. So if they can't knock me out this turn, we might have won the game. Oof, this is tough. This is tough. This is why I play like this style. Oh my gosh. No, he inted it. He straight up inted it. I can take this out with one hit. He doesn't have the energies attached to do any damage with this Pokemon. So he's stalling out, thinking that like he can keep it fine with this guy. But I just need this turn. If this guy survives this turn, I'm good. He should have played the Magnemite. If he wanted to stall out, he should have played the Magnemite. If he's not going to do any damage to me at the same time, yeah, for sure. Guessing he's missing energies or something like that. I'm feeling better. Feeling better about this pause that we're experiencing now. People have to think when they're under pressure. I'll put a little more pressure on. Oh my gosh! Okay, I think that's game, baby. That's game. That's fucking game right there. Oh yeah. Oh fuck yes. Put another therapeutic energy on. Take out the Zamazenta. There we go. Another two prize cards. Oh my. My gosh. Alright, so they can still win. Oh, and the RCSV is amazing. So they can still win. What they have to do is they have to have the Rare Candy Magnezone in here. And they have to be able to put on more than 5. They have to put 5 energies on. If they get 4 energies on, it's not enough. I have 20 HP left. As long as I can get in one hit with this guy onto this, I should have the game. That's the hope. Three energies would only do 120. I mean, 100... Wait. Wait, how did it... Oh, it's 40 plus. That's my bad. We have the second slacking up and running. We're just gonna hit. 220, there we go. One hit done. Very nice. Very, very, very nice. Oh, we're feeling good. So they have the Magnezone. So, the only way they win this is if they have a boss's orders and they swap the RCSV in and they get... Oh, they didn't even get the energies! They didn't even get the energies! Hell yes! Hell yes! That's what we like to see. That's the game, baby. That's the game. That's the game. Well played. Well played, sir. Amoeba TV. We go. We got another win. We got another win with our slacking Blissey deck. Hell yes. That's two wins and two losses, even on the day. All prize cards taken. Yes. Look at that. We have just enough disruption with the judges coming through to keep the hands this guy needed out of his hand. The cards this guy needed out of his hands. That's fine. That's fine. We'll take that. Okay. Oh, that's banging. That's banging. Two wins, two losses. I think I already collected both of these today. No, I didn't. More gems. And more coins. Fantastic. Cool, cool, cool. All right, let's do another. Let's do another. Get depressed again. Oh man, this is fun. I'm enjoying this deck. It's tricky. You have to think a lot. Cuz it's not that strong. It is not that strong at all. 240 is nice though. If you get like a slacking early on, right? If you manage to get one up for whatever reason, they don't have any of their V-Star Pokémon. They're all Pokémon V. Like you can take out Pokémon V with this guy with one hit. No problem. So that allows you to take out two prize cards, which is nice, you know. So really, this deck needs a lot more. I think it needs a lot more boss's orders. So you can pick and choose which Pokemon you're really trying to take out. But we'll see. Looks like it's going to be an electric deck. We're going up against a BCAC. We start with the Chansey. Not the greatest starts. It's not even letting us. Guessing this is going to be a Maraidon EX deck by someone not comfortable enough to play in ranked, because these decks really belong in ranked, but we will see what it turns out to be. It is a Zorora Pachirisu version of the Maraidon EX deck. Okay, fair enough. This is a much weaker version. It uses the single prize card Pokemon to like protect the Hensher Pokemon. Yeah, Maraidon incoming. You are correct, Phase Leader. Oh, we got the Raikou. We got just Regieleki V, though, it looks like. So I think it's just going to be the Regieleki V Max, and they're going to just boost all of these basic Pokemon's moves. I don't really see tons of benefit in this. 90 damage to an evolution Pokemon for one energy. That's not great. Your Pachirisu is really where it's at. You really want to load up your Pachirisu and retreat the Zorora. Basic energy. This is not looking good for us. We are going to use the Crushing Hammer to get rid of that. If we can. We can. We got the head. So they're going to discard that for us. Thank you very much. We are going to put the V-Guard energy on the Chansey because these are Pokemon V. And we're going to use the Youngster to reshuffle our hand. If we get a Blissey, that would be really nice. We got the Boost Shake and a Bidoof. We could use the Boost Shake on the Bidoof to get a Bibarel, or we could use the Boost Shake on the Chansey to get the Blissey, put another V-Guard energy on the Blissey, and then we lose. All right, we're going to use the Boost Shake on... Ah, man, I don't want to do this. And I think I could have played an energy still. No, he just, this is my first go. Okay. Sure. We'll do the Bibarel, because then we have the draw engine. The budget electric deck. Yeah, that's 100% right, Phase Leader. That's so funny. The budget Maraidon deck. That's what this is. Okay, so they're going to swap in my Bibarel. That's an interesting decision. They are going to attack it for 60 damage because it's an evolution Pokemon. Dang. Okay, well, I have a switch, so fuck you. Don't appreciate that at all. We're going to switch back. Thank you very much. Nice try. And we're going to use the Bibarel draw engine here. We got a reversal, and we got the Slackoth that we were looking for. That's great. So when this, we need the Blissey, really. Flip a coin until you get tails. This does 60 damage for each heads. That could be kind of OP. If you really leaned into the Chansey and the Blissey line, this could be very, very OP, honestly. I still am not playing this deck properly. I'm going to go out and say that straight up. It doesn't work on evolution Pokemon. Oh, it provides one energy. Okay. All right, so now we're going to go like this. What do we get? Ultra Ball and a Rezu. We could get the Blissey and load up the Vigoroth for next turn. I kind of don't want to do that. I kind of want to use this egg rolling. But hang on. The Rondo is going to do enough damage. 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120, 140, 160. Blissey's still not going to be strong enough to deal with that. However, the 150 will take this guy out, while as if I get a Tails Flip early, I would be screwed on that. So, we are going to go for the Blissey here. That's all I'm going to do, because I want to keep the Bibarel draw engine going. No problemo. Go Blissey here. We're going to use the Happy Cyclone. If I go Ultra Ball and I get rid of the Wigglytuff and the Reversal Energy and I get another Slaking. Oh, it's to one of your bench Pokemon. Okay, fuck that then. All right. No, we're not going to do that. We're going to hold the Ultra Ball. We're going to go Happy Cyclone. We're going to put them onto the Vigoroth. We're going to take out the Zeraora. No problemo. We're going to move them to here. Thank you very much. So they don't have any cards in their hand, which is really nice, because that means they don't have a ton of energies on hand. The chances of them getting like an energy and something, well, they do have the fleet-footed, so they're gonna get two cards. I'm hoping neither of them is an energy. I'm hoping they don't get like a Boss's Orders or a Judge or something like that as well. If we can evolve this Slaking, that would be perfect. Okay, so they're gonna take out the Blissey. That's all right. We are going to take out the Raikou, so they're not going to have access to that Pokemon anymore, which is going to be great. And they're going to have all their energy are going to be gone. So we're going to go Vigoroth here. Nice, 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 nice. And what do we get with our... We get the Arceus. Oh, my days. Perfect. So we're going to go like that. We're going to go Slaking here. I think we're going to use the Ultra Ball on the Wigglytuff and the Bibarel. Yeah, because it boosts our Bibarel draw. We're gonna go like that. We can grab ourselves the V-Star. I don't like doing this on the turn, because if they do have a Judge or something next turn and they get rid of it, then I've wasted the card, but that's okay. We're gonna go Industrious Scissors here. We got another Ultra Ball, so that's all right. We have a Boss's Orders. We don't want to use it right now. We do want to go double Turbo Energy onto... Ooh. Do we play the Reversal Energy? No. We're going to be ahead. So we're going to play the double Turbo onto the Arceus now. And we're going to go for the Slacker's Head Strike. We're going to take out this Raikou, no problem. We're going to get two prize cards. Fortunately, we have two Therapeutic Energy on this, as well as that Reversal Energy, the Revival Energy, shall I say. So, it doesn't really matter. We get another Chansey. That's great. Oh, and we didn't even stay asleep, even though we have the Therapeutic Energy on. Oh, those are V-Guard. Those are V-Guard Energy. Oh, we risked it there. Holy shit. I could have stayed asleep. That would have been bad. So the Pachirisu does what? It does 20 for each of your benched Pokemon. 20, 40, 60, 80. And then plus 60 is going to be 140. And they don't have the energy to attack with it, so I'm going to get to take that. Very nice. Very nice. All right, so we're going to go Chansey here. We're going to go Arceus here. Very nice. We're going to go for the V-Star Starbirth. So I want to grab the Blissey for sure. And then I think maybe another Slackoth. I think that makes the most sense. Actually, Avery might make sense because then it weakens the Pachirisu. Inspect the board. Yeah. Could we do that instead? If I did boss's orders in the Regieleki and attacked it, then they couldn't attack with it though. Done. I'm gonna take the Avery. I know it's not the best idea, but that's okay. We're gonna go Avery now. We're gonna draw three cards. Oh, we got the Slackoth as well. That's so nice. So we get the Slackoth. We weaken the Pachirisu, no problem. I guess we would put the therapeutic energy. We'll put the reversal energy onto the Slackoth. I think that's it. I think we're just going to go for the Slacker's Head Strike. We're going to go 240. We're going to knock out this Pachirisu. We get down to two. Prize cards, we go to sleep. Obviously, we play the Blissey next turn. So I'm guessing they're not expecting that. I don't think they're going to... I mean, unless they get the electric... unless they get the electric generator, they can't put more than one energy onto the Regieleki VMAX. So I'm not too concerned... Oh, they have the Meridian. Okay. The nice thing is I'm going to boss his order. Oh, I'm going to boss his orders in for the Meridian. That's the game. They just lost themselves the game right there. I was going to have to deal with these Regieleki VMAX, but it's like, now I'm all good. So we got heads and we did not get the second heads. That's okay. That's okay. And we do have two therapeutic energy in our hand. We don't need them. We have this Blissey, so we're just going to play the Blissey here. That 60 damage per heads is sneaky strong, actually. That's really, really sneaky strong. We are going to go for the Meridon here. Sure. Probably should have gone for the Raikou, but as soon as I saw the Meridon, I was like, oh, that's game. So, well, I'm just going to go for the Meridon. We got the game against the Meridon EX with the Slacking Blissey deck. Look at that. Holy fucking shit, man. Look at that. Pulling it out. Three. Wins on the day. Oh my god, look at that. Ah, I gotta press select. That's so lame. Three wins on the day. 3-2. Oh my gosh. Pulling ahead. GG. GG, BKAC. 910 damage. Not doing too bad today. Look at that. Slacking Blissey coming out big. Coming out big. I'm liking it. This is good. This is a good, fun deck to play. All right, do we do another? Do I do it? Yeah, let's go for another. I think I have enough beer to last me until my next bathroom break. I think that's... Yeah. Oh, we got some jazz glasses on. Jay Ozaki coming in here with the Gengar skins. Okay. Looking like a psychic deck. Could be, potentially, would be my guess. With the Ducklet coin, though. That's not Ducklet. That's Quaxley. My bad. The Quaxley coin. And they got heads. Are they a head caller? They are a head caller. Okay. Like-minded. Like-minded player, opponent. Let's go. Let's go. Your opponent's going first. Again, that's what I would have done. Gengar, okay. We do not have any basic Pokemon, so we're going to mulligan. That's not a very good start for us. We're going to see. Hopefully, we get a decent start with this. We got two mulligans. Holy shice. And it's the Arceus V start. Not great. Not great. Do not have much to do here. That sucks. And it's going to be the United Wings deck. We already played this deck earlier. I did lose to this deck earlier. Once you start taking single price cards, you really got to take the single price cards. They have a squawk ability, which I do not have in mine. So that's something to note. I have seen this in many. I'm not the biggest fan of it. I know you get to restart your whole hand, so it's kind of useful. But I should probably play it, actually. I should probably put that in my United Wings deck. They're going for the Ralts Curlia draw engine as well. Okay, so this is a very similar deck to mine, minus the Squawk ability. Let's see what else they have. Discard their hand. They're getting rid of all three Flamigo. Very nice. So they're doing 30 damage right now. No, it's 80, 60 damage currently. How many? Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 100 damage. Wow. And they couldn't go. Okay, a Vigoroth. That's not helpful at all. We are going to have to use the Crushing Hammer here. We got it. We are going to take that energy away. I hope they do not have another one. We're going to see. I don't know. We're going to play the basic energy here. I'm really stuck right now. This is a very bad start for us. And I doubt they have more than one Squawk ability in their deck, so they had a very good start for them, which sucks for us. Okay, they got the Curlia up and running. They got both Curlia up and running. Wow. Their deck is working really well right now. They got a great hand, and it's working really well. Oh, they got rid of the Gallade. Interesting. Maybe they needed an energy. Maybe they don't have an energy for the Murkrow. That would be fantastic for me. What are they discarding? Not an energy. Okay, so they got one energy there. This is a pretty low energy deck normally. They got a double turbo energy, but they cannot attack. Nice, so we stalled out one turn. Very nice. And how many Pokemon are in here now? 1, 2, 3. Oh, it's the same. 4, 5. So it's still 100. Still 100 damage. Of course, once they get enough in there, they're just going to one-hit the Slaking, and the damage output that he does is not going to matter. You know what would be really nice would be a Chansey, honestly, with that flip coin move. If they take the Arceus as well, my reversal energy will be operational. There's the Ditto. Okay, so they are playing Ditto as well in this deck. It's very, very similar to mine. The only difference so far is the Squawk ability and that retro-ass switch card they had. Radiant Jirachi! That's what I like to see. I don't want to put... We're just going to do one. That's fine. We're going to put it on the Arceus. I don't think they're going to get up to 220 next turn. I hope not. They only have two cards in their hand, so I don't know. They do have the draw engine, the Curlia draw engine. Don't count it out. It's very OP. But they seem kind of limited right now. Double turbo energy. They're attaching it to Ditto, so they're not going to be attaching it to the Murkrow. They're hoping for a switch. They got the Professor's Research, which is nice, but they did not add any more Pokemon. So they're still at 100. So I need to get access to this Squawk ability EX. That's what I need. Interesting. So they have to get rid of one of their cards. Ah, damn. They just saved themselves. If I had gotten the boss's orders, I could have taken out the Squawk ability EX. Fuck, it's like they're listening to me. Damn. That was a good move. That was a very good move at that point in the game. I don't think it has a retreat cost either. So they... Oh, it's got one. It's got one. Yeah, if I'd been able to get a boss's orders, if I'd gotten the V-Star, then I could have taken that out, and I would have been in a very good spot, honestly. We have a Clavel, though, so that's okay. We're going to go Clavel instead. We're going to grab the Chansey that we were hoping for. We're going to grab a bit of. I'm gonna grab a Slakoth, I think. That's very nice. That's a nice mix of Pokemons that we have there. We're gonna go Slakoth here. We're gonna go Chansey here. We're gonna go Bidoof here. So what should I do?
Should I put the Reversal Energy on?
If they take out the Arceus V, they're gonna be ahead. So I'm gonna put it on the Chansey for now. Because obviously the Chansey can disperse it if it gets knocked out. We're just gonna use the Power Edge. We're gonna do 130 damage. We're gonna take out this Murkrow. Obviously it's gonna add 20 damage to their total damage output, but we get a prize card. We start the roll. We have a rare candy now, so we can evolve the Slakoth straight into the Slaking. We can use the Vigoroth as things to get rid of. However, it might make more sense considering how tricky the Slaking is. To just use the Vigoroth for the Sharp Claws. 60 more damage if you get heads. That would take out both of these guys. That would take all of them out. I prefer to take them out in one, to be honest, but we'll see. So we have one. Very nice. And this does not have United Wings either. Okay, perfect. So it's one. So it's just 120 right now that we're dealing with. And they don't seem to have what they need. What are they... Oh, what are they doing? What are they? Oh, it must be energy, right? Energy and Gallade. Okay, so they're going to use the Gallade to deal with the Arceus V, I think. Because it does damage based on your V Pokemon. We're going to see. You know what would have been cool is if the Slaking was Slaking EX and it had like 250 HP and 240. That'd be kind of cool. Okay. Oh, we have a judge. That's so brutal on these decks. We're gonna rare candy in for our Slaking now. No problem. And now we're gonna judge. We're gonna get rid of 10 cards in their hand. Boost their deck back up. They're only gonna get 4 cards back. Oh man, we really disrupted them pretty hard there. And we get the Blissey, so we can play the Blissey, and we get the Bibarel. So we get the Bibarel draw engine. Oh my gosh, that was perfect. That was so perfect. We're going to put the double turbo energy onto the Radiant Jirachi, I think. We have a youngster as well. Oh, that's fantastic. So we are going to go Industrious Incisors. What do we get? Nothing huge. Nothing we can really use. I could switch the Arceus V out and use the Radiant Jirachi. No confirmation that we are going to get the knockout, though. So I think the best idea is to keep taking out their Pokemon that have weak... because they don't have a ton of energies, right? So we're going to take out the Pokemon that have the energies attached, which is good. And on top of that, that Ditto is not going to add to their total. So they have one... So it's just the 100 still. Holy cow. No, because he had... No, yes, it's going to be 100 because he's got double turbo on here as well. Oh, we are crushing through this United Wings deck pretty quick. And if they take the Arceus V, I guess we'd be tied. So the Reversal Energy will still not work. We're going to see. We're going to see... They might get something. They might get like a Professor's Research and have a bunch of United Wings cards in their hand. They got rid of a Ralts. Interesting. They got rid of a Ralts. And the Gallade. So they don't even have United Wings Pokemon in their hand to be discarding. What's this guy do? You can search for a supporter card, I think. Can I look at the card, please? Once during your turn, you may search your deck for a supporter card. Yeah, that's what I thought. So they might be going for Professor's Research or something. I didn't see what they took. We're gonna see. This is tricky. I wonder if they don't have the damage. They don't have the damage to take the Arceus V out this turn. Which means I can put another reversal energy onto the Blissey, or I could put the V-Guard energy onto the Blissey even. And save up for next turn. Oh, who are they going for? They're going for the Blissey. Do they have enough damage though? I have a switch, so I'm not super concerned about that. that, but do they have enough damage to take my Blissey or not? No, they don't. Fantastic. Oh, that's fantastic. Okay. All right. So we got a Bibarel. First things first, we're going to switch. Do we go for the Jirachi? Or the RCSV? I think maybe we go for the Jirachi. We're gonna go for the RCSV. They're gonna knock it out next turn. I know this for a fact. We're gonna attach a V-Guard energy to the Blissey. We are gonna go for the Youngster now. And we are gonna hope we get the RCSV star. That would be killer. That would be killer. We did not get it. We did get another Blissey though. That's okay. We got the therapeutic energy. It's kind of what we were hoping for anyways. So we are going to go for the Power Edge here. Honestly, if I had a Boss's Orders, I would really want to swap in for that Ditto. Because the double turbo is going to prevent this guy from doing 100, and that would not add to it. But we don't have our Boss's Orders. And we already used the Youngster. So that's okay. I could retreat. I could still retreat and use the Radiant Jirachi. Not too concerned right now. The difficulty with this deck is that all the Pokemon have such low HP that it's really easy to take them out. That tends to be the trouble. So even though they can kind of hit hard later on, it's tricky. We're gonna see what they get. And they can go for another supporter card, actually, with that Gallade once per turn, I'm pretty sure. So they have the damage to take out the RCSV now. That's fine. Yeah, so the nice thing is, though, they're going to take out the RCSV. They're going to go down to 4. I'm going to attach the therapeutic energy to Blissey, and I'm going to take out the Ditto. So I'm going to go to 2. They can take out the Blissey. I can immediately dispense those energies to the Slaking. And I can take out another. So I'll be down to 1. And they'll be down to 3 at that point. So then I can use the Radiant Jirachi a little bit. Or maybe I throw out another Blissey. We'll see. I have the Clavel. So actually the smartest thing to do would be to set up another Blissey. That would be the best thing. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take out this RCSV would be my guess. I'll play the Blissey forward, I'll play the Clavel, I'll grab a Chansey, I'll put the Chansey on the bench. I'll play the therapeutic energy to the Blissey, I'll attack with the Blissey, knock out the Ditto. Yeah, this could be good. We're gonna see. Play the Blissey. Okay, what did we get? Jack. Okay, so we're gonna go Clavel here. Because the Blissey move disperses the energy to your basic, to your bench Pokemon. So I can go like this. And I can go like this. And I can use the Happy Cyclone now. Bang. I can take out this Ditto. And I can put the energies onto the Chansey. So now, they either can't take out this Blissey, which they might not even have a Pokemon to do it, actually, now that I think about it. I don't have a Switch. I have the RCSV star now. Fantastic. It was in the price cards. Cool. Okay, so they got the Gallade in play. Not an attacker. They're not going to attack this turn. That's fine. I can't apply the reversal energy and retreat with it because it only counts as 1 right now. We could get a double turbo. I don't think I've discarded a bunch of them. We haven't gotten a single one yet. So we could get a double turbo. That would make it really easy. We could retreat this Blissey. We could throw the new Blissey up. We could take out the Galley. We would have one prize card left. That'd be pretty nice. And I hadn't thought about it, but you can actually, yeah. If you have a bunch of switches in this deck, you can, like, just keep switching these Blisseys out. Oh my gosh, they didn't have anything. V-Guard Energy. Okay. All right. That's a game. We got 4 wins with the Slacking Blissey deck. 4 wins and 2 losses. Look at that. Taking out the United Wings deck. Not bad. Not bad. Whew. Very nice. Okay. We're back. Right back into another game with Slacking Blissey deck. 4 wins. 4 wins, 2 losses. Not bad. Very happy. I can't retreat the Blissey. I'm just conceding, man. Fuck this shit. 2 mulligans. His deck is already set up. It's already set up. I have no chance against a competitive deck like that. Don't say excellent battle. You're not playing any egg-themed Pokemon. If you were playing Chansey, you could say egg-themed battle. There you go. But no. I discredit you for that. All right. So we conceded that. I did not feel like trying to play against when they have such a good setup and we have such a bad setup and they have the mulligan advantage. Their deck is already very, very strong. It's a competitive deck. They shouldn't be playing it in casuals and they should know better. But obviously, you can't help some people. They're going to take the ranked decks and they're going to play them in casual standard. It's whatever. Okay, we got Red Gabriel 56017. We are going up against what looks like a fire type deck. Exciting times. Gonna see how Slacking Blissey deals with this. Did we beat the Arcanine deck? I think we beat that deck. I wasn't too impressed with the gameplay though. I don't think they were playing that deck properly. So they have the fire coin, they have the fire deck box, more than likely going to be a fire deck. I'm guessing the Arcanine EX, it tends to be the strongest right now with Charizard attached onto the side. Could be anything. Could be Skeledirge. Oh man, that would be scary. Another mulligan game! Fantastic! We have a ton of bench Pokemon in here. We have 20 Pokemon in that deck. Somehow we're still getting 2 mulligans in a row! Incredible bad luck here. Okay, so just 1 mulligan this time. Nice. Not a great starting hand. Only 1 Pokemon. And obviously, like, if we'd had 2 Pokemon, then we could have played 1 here and 1 here and put the revival energy, the reversal energy on that one, and when this one gets taken out, we can attack. Not gonna be the same. Oh, we got a Bidoof. I'm gonna go therapeutic energy for now. Yeah, because when we get the Vigoroth up and running, we could do 40 damage. We'll see. If we get the double turbo, we might even be able to take out the Growlithe very quickly, but I would assume that they're gonna have more Pokemon. We will see. Looks like maybe not. Maybe they just go for the Stoke. Go for the Stoke. Attach 2 fire energies from their pile to their Growlithe. And move on. Hit for 70 damage next turn. No burn. So we'll be able to evolve. And we'll be safe with the Vigoroth for now. Use the Zhat to go and grab a Bibarel. Get the Bibarel engine up and running. Maybe grab a Chansey or something. Maybe the Arceus V-Star. Yeah, interesting. So they don't have any more basic Pokemon. We're going to see. If we get a double turbo energy, we might be able to end the game right here. So we're going to see. What do we got? Or a rare candy. Rare candy would do it as well. No rare candy. So we're going to go Vigoroth. Yeah. I'm going to go for the Jacques here. I'm going to grab the Bibarel. I would love to grab... okay, whatever. We'll grab the RC3 star. It means we can't use our Bibarel draw engine, though. Oh, no, we can for 1. We're going to put a basic energy onto the Vigoroth here. We are not going to be able to attach a double turbo if we get it, which sucks, but that's how you have to play it. Oh, we got the Arezu. Not bad. Cool. So we'll go confront here. Got the 40. We'll see. For them to not get another basic Pokemon on their bench would be surprising. I would be very surprised by that, but they might just have very bad luck. We might just have very good luck. We'll see what happens. Hey, so that's probably going to be the game. They're going to take out the Vigoroth. I do not have another attacker. I do not have any bench Pokemon. We will be able to play the Bibarel with the reversal energy because we will be down a prize card. But, yeah, that's unfortunate for us. You didn't need to attach that fire energy. Oh, I guess it's a discard, isn't it? So, yeah, he did. Never mind. Never mind. He's going to attack for 250. I guess I'll attack for maybe 100 if I get the coin flip for the Bibarel. It depends on what I pull here. Interesting, okay. I don't know what this guy's doing. There you go. Oh! Okay! That's weird. I was not expecting that. Interesting decision. I can't use the rare candy. That's not helpful now. Holy cow. Holy cow. Yo, that's... He just lost. He literally could have won this game. He literally could have won this game, and he lost the game instead by stalling out for one turn. Oh, we got another win. Fucking right. Hey, look at that. We'll take the prize, guys. We'll take the win. Hey, man, I've had sloppy games before, too. It happens. It happens. Sometimes you just get a little full of yourself, and you're like, you know, I got time. Wasn't expecting the slacking. Wasn't ready for the move? Okay, alright, so we'll sneak that win out. We got 5 wins on the day, 3 losses with the Slacking Blissey deck. Not bad. Oh my goodness, I am surprised at that. That was a little bit of silliness. That makes me, oh my gosh, that's funny as hell. I can't believe he just did that. That's so funny. Why would you do that? Like, why? Just do the 250, discard the 2 energy. Maybe he didn't have another energy in his hand. That's the risk you gotta take. Oh, whatever. I win. That's fine. I'll take the win. Okay, Just Pokemaster. All right, we're going up against what looks like a Steel-type deck, potentially. I didn't look at the deck box or any of that, so we're gonna see. Right. Flipping one coin. They got tails. Did they call tails? They did not. We get to pick. Thank you. Yes, I will go first. All right. Let's see what the deck is we are up against. Let's see what our hand is. Hopefully it's not another mulligan. It's not another mulligan. We have a Jigglypuff to start the game. Fuck it, eh? All right. We'll play the Jigglypuff here. We do have a judge. We have a Nest Ball, so we can go grab a Bibarel. We'll grab the Bidoof with the Nest Ball and then judge out the hand. Would be my thought. They have a Bidoof to start. It's my turn. Okay. Okay. We have a rare candy as well. We are going to go Nest Ball, though. We are going to go and grab the Bidoof. No problem. Could have gone for the Radiant Jirachi. Could have retreated this guy and had it in there as a stand, but that's okay. We're going to attach an energy to... 20 damage for each of your bench Pokemon that have the Let's All Roll Out. So none of them. Okay, so we're going to attach the Steel Energy to the Arceus V. We're going to end our turn there. We're going to see. We do not know what kind of deck we are up against still. Normal Pokemon cards. Steel type coin, though. Yeah, I really don't like the colors they picked for the normal background. I don't know why you would pick that. Like, what even is that? Is that normal? That's not normal. They could have done... Like, what could they actually do for the normal instead of what they've got? Because what they've got looks dumb. They could just have a city. They could have, like a training court. You know? Like a clay Pokemon court arena. You know? Rather than... What the fuck is this? Hideous. That's what it is. It's hideous. Therapeutic energy. All right, we're going to go liberal here. We are going to attach the therapeutic energy to that, though. Yeah, if we could start attacking with the RCSV, that'd be good. All right, we're going to go judge now. We are only going to get 4 cards. Might be helping them. That's always the risk you got to take. We got another Bidoof. Very nice. We got a rare candy. We have a Clavel as well. That's very nice. So we can use the Bibarel again. What else do we get? Another Clavel and a Boss's Order. So we can actually take out the Magnemite pretty quick if we need to. If we need to. So next turn, I believe we would probably go Clavo. We'll probably grab the Slaking and a Chansey. Slakoth and a Chansey. Put the basic energy on the RCSV. Use the Bibarel draw engine. See what we can get. And then hopefully swing the RCSV in and take out the Bidoof. Got another judge. Okay, we're going to go Clavel here. Chansey. Ooh, do we want the Jirachi instead of the Slakoth? We'll go for all three. And we'll fuck ourselves on the Bibarel draw. That's all right. I think we go Chansey here. And then I think we go Radiant Jirachi. That's the idea. And then we go basic energy onto the RCSV. And we can't do anything else. Fuck. Okay. Just Pokemaster. Steel deck coming back from behind. It's going to be a little tricky. We did beat the Dialga V earlier. I don't think they played that deck very well. So we're going to see if this guy is going to do better. No, we get the win again, too. I guess this deck is just super strong against the Dialga V-Star deck, because that's the second one we've beaten in a row. Sorry to do it to you, Josh Pokemaster, but that's going to be our game. Very nice. Very nice. 6 wins. 6 wins and 3 losses on the day with the slacking Blissey deck. That's impressive. I'm very surprised. That's better than the United Wings deck. That's better than the Meowscarada deck, the EX deck that I did. That's better than the Quaquavel EX deck that I did. Holy, Slaking Blissey, man. That's the game. Congrats. All right, so last game of the day was a fucking loss, unfortunately. Oh, that's a shame. We were close. We were close on that. Okay. So that's going to be it from me today. I hope everyone that came along for the stream had a good time. I had a pretty good time for most of it. It was pretty fun. We were actually beating a couple of decks. The end result is going to be 6-4 with the Slaking Blissey deck. So it's better than I had expected or hoped for. We did go against some pretty competitive decks in there as well. So that's very nice to know. I definitely recommend taking this out, maybe adding a different card or something. I think you can make it work. I don't think I have the right combination of cards just yet, but hopefully I will get there soon. So below me on the screen there are 2 links. The red link is to my YouTube. That is MD Tenebris Plays Pokemon. All of my past catalog is back there if you want to go and watch any of the videos. I have competitive decks, I have non-competitive decks. It's all there. The deck list will be in the description of the video as well, so feel free to go and check that out. Mess around with it, put your own versions together. You know, I love to see that kind of creativity come out. I love to see interesting synergies in the Pokemon world. The purple link is for my Twitch. That's where I am right now. You can catch me live on Saturday at 2 p.m. or on Monday at 6:30. I'm here. I'm playing. Feel free to join the chat. Make fun of me. Contribute. Give me advice. Any of it's welcome. Feel free. I have a link in the Discord. I have a link in the description box. It's for a Discord channel. If you want to get me offline, talk to me about anything Pokemon related. Maybe discuss finding a deck list on one of my videos and making it better and then telling me about it on the Discord. It's all good. Feel free. I love talking about Pokemon, so feel free to join. Everyone's welcome. So yeah, that's going to be it from me today. I want to thank Phase Leader. Right at the start of the stream, showing up there the whole time. I really appreciate it, man. It's good to have you. Come hang out with me and Phase Leader. That's going to be it for me today. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day or evening, wherever you are. I hope you get a very nice, good night's sleep tonight. And I hope you wake up and have a wonderful rest of your weekend. That is going to be it from me. That's MD Tenebris. I'm signing off now. Peace out. Adios. Take it easy.